put on some shoes.
Check out my socks.
Hello, fast trackers. Now I've got to keep an eye on the button over there. Make sure it stays green. My name's Darryl. I'm from Fast Track Piano, and I'm here for the next 30 minutes to help you. Let me know what you want to do. I've been a piano teacher for as long as I can remember, over 30 years now, and I've got a room full of students here each day. It's fantastic. People come to me and learn piano, and now I'm taking it to the world through my website and through live broadcasts. A couple of days ago, we had a little bit of a technical glitch. I just got to keep my eye on the... I'll be turning around just to make sure that it's still going. Anyway, I want to help you with your piano playing. The piano is such a great thing to play. All you do is put your finger on it. There it is. Sounds great. I got a violin over there, saxophone. I bought a clarinet with some reeds the other day. I've never really played clarinet properly. I bought the wrong reeds. It's a hard instrument to get a sound out of when you've got the wrong reeds in there. So I've got to go and get some new reeds. Anyway, let's go on. Weather report. I'm in Sydney, Australia right now. It's black outside. It's the shortest day of the year. Summer is coming for us. but, you know, it's only 10 degrees and 19, we're getting up to 19. It's hardly winter, is it, compared to people around the world. Today we're going to have a bit of everything. Bit of rain, a bit of sunshine, a bit of cloud. There we go. Okay, let's get on with the show then. And let's have a look at the very first thing we got up there today. What'd you think of my socks? Eh? Pretty good, eh? They're very warm. All right. Now this is a piece of music from the Fast Track catalog. If you go onto the website, you can see hundreds of videos there that you can learn. And this is a song called All My Loving. Right. It's a Beatles song, of course. Originally, the first time I heard this song, it was really slow. And it was sung at the end of a kid's talent show called Young Talent Time. And the guy who hosted the show, Johnny Young, was a mad Beatle fan. And he used to sing it really slowly and gently. It was beautiful. And then when I heard the Beatles do it, I thought, wow, this is different. It was so different. I actually liked the slower version. Anyway, let's try it. Here we go. And there it is. Now let's just have a look at it. You can see in the top right hand corner there that it's got a big C next to the treble clef. Now that means common time, which the most common time signature is 4-4, which means four crotchet beats to the bar. And it's so common that sometimes they just put a big fat C there. Now you can see that there's only two crotchets in the first bar. So what's going on there? Well, that's called an anacrusis. And a lot of songs start with anacrusis, and this one does too. It means it starts on the third beat of the bar, and somewhere at the end you're going to add the other two again. So it doesn't start on the first beat of the bar. Let's just play the first couple of bars in the right hand. You got F, down to E, down to D, up. Now we've run out of fingers. We've got to go up to an A. Now, what would be a good idea? How should we approach that? Well, possibly a good each way bet is to actually use your third finger. If you've got your third finger to start off with, you've got two fingers either side just to keep things going. Let's try our third finger to start off with and see what happens. So we've got number three on F there. Okay, so we made it to the bottom note. We don't need any more down there and we've got no fingers left. So that's sort of worked out. Now we're going to go up. Okay, now we've got to go to a B. And we've got no fingers left, so we're going to have to rethink how we're going to do the next phrase. So I like to put my third finger on. Anyway, so there you go. That could be a little bit of a tip for you. Notice the melody goes by scale. It sort of goes... It's not one of those songs that jumps around a lot, like this one might. It's Can't Buy Me Love. That jumps around by bigger intervals rather than scales. Let's have a look at the left hand. Now it starts off with D minor, and you've got a D minor down here, and D, F, and A, and we're going to play it as an arpeggio. That means a broken chord. And there's all sorts of ways you can play a chord. You can just play it like I call it plonk. You just go plonk like that. Or you can break it up. You could go bottom, middle, top like this. Or you could, because there's four beats in the bar, maybe you could go bottom, middle, top, middle. So. And that's in fact the version that we're doing here. We've got bottom, middle, top, middle. Now these piano lessons I've got online are they're simple piano lessons, right? They're not too hard. There's two different levels. You've got just the plonk version with a melody in the right hand, and you've got level two, which has got the arpeggio versions, which can get a lot harder because you're trying to play left hand with the right hand. I'm not... espousing huge arrangements here. We're not doing anything really hard. These are just simple little arrangements, and you can take it easy by just learning the right hand first. Just play the right hand first, you know. Enjoy that. Then eventually you could learn the chords and then add a little bit at a time. That's the wonderful thing about these videos. You can just play them over and over again until you get it right. Okay, so I'll just play the first little bit again. Here we go. Both hands. There you go. All my loving. Okay, so let's say hello to a few people. Hello. G'day, Stephen. How are you? Good to see you. Stephen, I got something special for you. Ivy. Hello, Ivy. I hope, wake up, Darryl. I Fall to Pieces is coming along. Let me know in an email how it's going and how I could make it easier for you. Frank. G'day, Frank. You checked out our little rehearsal the other night. That was a bit sneaky. G'day, Trisha. Hey, Alfie. Hollywood Alfie. Do I know any Miami songs? I don't know. Yeah, there is a Miami song. Was it John Cougar Mellencamp? Did he have a Miami song? I think so. G'day, Jackson. How you going? Thanks for tuning in, folks. We had a bit of a glitch the other day, but that's all behind us, hopefully. We've got green lights over here. Yeah. Now, I know this seems like we're going on forever, but... you know, I'm making this up as I go along. I've got a little sheet here of my little things that I try and do each day in the 30 minutes that I'm doing this thing. But it doesn't have to be like this. I could just sit here and talk to you, and you could just let me know what you want me to show you. And because there's a fair bit of preparation goes into this, because I want to do a good job, you know, and people can look back later and actually see these videos and learn a little bit from them. We're just doing a little bit of each thing. It's not a big deal, but I'm still trying to get the format together. And if you've got any ideas, let me know. Let me know what you think, what you like and what you don't like. Everybody's going to be different. There's quite a few people that like old country songs. I was thinking the other day, maybe we could have just Country Friday, you know, put the hat on and just do old country songs on Friday. That's all we do for half an hour. Take requests, muck around, just do stuff like that. And maybe have a classical Thursday or something like that. I don't know. We're just making it up. Look, I don't want to get too serious about it. But I can't help myself. Okay, let's look at the B flat major scale. Yeah, here it is again. Now, if you're just tuned in for the first time, we do this as part of our little routine. We're learning the scale of the month. There's 12 scales, 12 major scales, and B-flat's our scale of the month. We start on second finger. You can see the fingers written up there on the top for the right hand. Now you've got to put your thumb under. Come on, do it. Thumb under. Come on, let's do it. Let's do it again. Here we go. Right. Let's do left hand. Starts on third finger. You can see down there, left hand is third finger. Now you cross over with your fourth. And you got one left, so you put your second finger up there. We'll try that again. Start on three. B flat major. There it is. The common chords in B flat major are, and we'll need this, need these chords for this song we're going to do at the end of the lesson today. B flat, it's B flat, D and F. C minor, that's C, E flat and G. D minor, that's D, F and A. E flat, that's E flat, G and B flat. F, that's F, A and C. And G minor, G, B flat and D. There you go. Now, if you wanted to, you could add one more note to make all these chords sexy. Instead of having those three, add another one, an A, so you get this. Whoa, that's called B-flat maj 7. And then just instead of C minor like that, you add this note. That's C minor 7. Instead of just to that, add this note. That's D minor 7. Oh, nice stuff. And add a D to an E-flat chord, you wouldn't think it'd work. But if you add these other notes, it sounds pretty. And this next one, F7, not so pretty, more funky. And G minor 7, add a... So that's the common chords with an added jazzy note to them all. Bit hard to play that one, you've got to put your fingers in here. Remember when we were doing the ocean and the boat? And we were just mucking around? Just mucking around on B flat major scale in the right hand. Isn't it? I got a song for you that uses nice chords. Okay, it's still working. Now, usually I put on a rock and roll song to wake everybody up. I'll just ring the bell instead. We're doing a nice gentle song. Okay, now this is this part of the lesson. I'm teaching you how to accompany somebody who likes to sing. If you've got people who come to your house who like to sing, this is what you do. You wouldn't play the tune in the right hand and the chords in the left hand. Well, you could, but it sounds a bit like a Sunday school teacher, you know? It's a little bit acky-dacky. So you need to play nice chords so they can sing the melody over the top of those chords. And in this song, this has got some really nice chords in it. A Van Morrison song, Have I Told You Lately? Irish! Okay. Now, play a B-flat chord. And the next chord is D minor 7. Oh, that's the chord I just showed you. So it's a D minor with a 7. So you got a B-flat going to D minor 7. Just making sure it's all working there. And then E-flat maj 7, what a chord this is. Actually, that's a Paul McCartney song, isn't it? I love you. Boo-doo-boo-boo-boo. Some na-na-da-da-da-da-da. And silly love songs. Same chord progressions turn up in different songs. Now the next chord is F-sus-4. F-sus-4, what the is that? Here's an F. Now, if you play this note, B-flat instead of A, you get F-sus-4. Come on, Ivy, try these chords. We know you like to sing. F, B flat, and C. If you do a big fat version, it's like this. And that's most of the song, right there. You got a B flat chord to D minor 7, to E flat maj 7, to F sus 4. That's most of the song. Do it one more time. B flat, D minor 7, E flat maj 7, F sus 4. Now, we won't do it in this lesson, but you may notice that that sounds a little bit grumpy. On some pianos, that's a little bit grumpy down low. So what you might do is put the D, this note, on top. So you move that around to here. So that sounds a little bit nicer. Yeah? And then you go to D minor 7. Okay. In the second line, we've got E flat maj 7. Da da ba da da da. It's got a D on top. Da da ba da da da. C minor 7. C minor 7 slash F. What is this? I give up. No, it's not. It's not that bad. You got C minor 7. There it is. Left hand changes to F. Wow. There you go. Back to B flat. So just to do C minor 7 with slash F again. Stick with it. F minor 7. What am I talking about? C minor 7 slash F. There it is. Okay, let's try the song. Now, I know there might be a few people out here. I remember when Rod Stewart first brought this out, I had a fellow in here and he said, oh, he's ruined the song. What's he done that song for? Okay, you know, good old Rod, he's still around, he's as popular as ever. Yeah, this is a nice version. Let's have a listen.
Oh yeah, now go back to sleep now. Stay awake.
Have I told you lately that I love you? Have I told you there's no one else above you? Fill my heart with gladness, take away all my sadness, ease my troubles, that's what you do. For the morning sun and all its glory greets the day with hope and comfort too. You fill my life with laughter, and somehow you make it better. Ease my troubles, that's what you do. There's a love that's divine, and it's yours and it's mine, like the sun. I told you lately that I love you.
You want to have an Elvis
have
special?
There's no one else above you. Fill my heart with gladness, take away all my sadness, ease my troubles, that's what you do.
Okay, so there you go. That's a nice little song in the key of B flat, which we've been doing. So you got B flat. Now, if you could move gently instead of going plonk, you could go maybe. That's a little bit tricky. Maybe we could do something simpler than that. Lots of different things you could do. You could do a country version. It's all about the dance. It's all about the dance. Anyway, you can have some fun with that. Let's move on. Make sure it's working, Darryl.
Yeah, it's working great. Here we go. Left hand. Okay, bass clef. Wow, that's way down the bottom there. That's an F below G. The bottom line is G. Great big dogs from Africa. Just starting to get light out there. F. Did you get it? Next one. Now there's the G. Great big dogs from Africa. That's a G. Wonderful. Hey, do you want to just have an Elvis channel? Just do Elvis stuff. And that's what we could do. You could have Elvis Mondays. You know? Can't please everybody. I've got to do a bit of everything. But I'd like to hear what you got to say. I read the live chat at the end of the lesson so I can see what everybody said. I don't get a chance to read it now. This note is B, right up the top here. Rightio, this is in the space. All cows eat grass. All cows eat grass. All cows eat. Now, you got to learn to read. If you don't learn to read, you won't have all those music books that you can refer to when you need a teacher. Although, what I'm going to show you today, you don't need to read because I've just got letters written down. It's sort of a cheating way of doing it. Here we go. All cows eat grass. That's a G. All cows eat grass. G, ba-da. We're up to double figures. That's good. Say hello, folks, if you've never said hello. Say hello. We love to hear from you. Just say hello on the live chat there and introduce yourself. We're all pretty friendly. All cows eat grass. Well, most of us anyway. A. That's the end of that. Ta-da. Rightio, let's move on. We're going to do our chord of the day. Look at these. Just check these chords out. Look how many there are. Okay, let's see what happens. We've got one here. B maj 7. How do you do that? What is this? Well, here's a B. Let's play it down here. Now, a B chord is B, D sharp, and F sharp. There it is. As opposed to B flat. Well, that sounds like an Elvis song. I'll stop it, Darryl. Now, the top note is maj 7. Now, what's that mean? You go up an octave and come down a semitone. There it is. You've got to have that note on top. Sounds bad, but if you add all the notes in there, you got that nice sound. Now, we just did a maj 7 chord in, have I told you lately, the E-flat maj 7. Now we got this. If you play a whole bunch of these maj 7s, they sound really cool, you know. Wow. You can sit there all day just dabbling around with those things. It's very relaxing. Okay, so that's that. What do we do now? Card games. We do the next part of the lesson. I've got a song to play for you. I'm going to call this the song of the week. Let's see what I've got here.
Yes!
Oh, let's go back. Hang on, I forgot the...
Yes!
Oh, having a moment. Beautiful song. Yeah, that's from Nashville. A little song called I Have a Life That's Good. And I definitely do. And we're trying to bring a bit of joy to people with the piano. And music's such a wonderful thing. It's can be free, you know. We just need an instrument and away we go. We don't even need that. We can just hit some rocks and have some fun with music. This is a lovely song, and I know Steve went to see Nashville concert, and that was very good. Now... That's a beautiful song from the TV show. Now, I've made a blue here. That's in the key of C major, which would have been easy to teach. But I went on to Spotify and I got this version.
Sitting here tonight by the firelight.
Different key.
It reminds me I already have
B flat
more than I should. I don't need fame, no one to know my name at the end of the day. I have a life that's good.
Okay, can you see me? I'm up in the top right-hand corner. Not that you need to see me. Now, this is just a rough version of this song. And it's in the key of B-flat. All the other versions on YouTube are actually in C. Ah! Anyway, we're going to do it in B-flat. Now, let's have a look at that. We've got the words up there. I hope you can read that okay. So, you got... Sitting here tonight by the firelight, it reminds me I already have more than I should. Okay, that's the first two lines. We've got the words written roughly underneath there. And in the left hand, we've got a B flat chord. Right, now I've actually got little dots there. Black means black note, B flat. Then you've got two white notes. That might be able to help you. So you've got a B flat chord. Stick with it, Ivy. You can do it. E flat, black, white, black. Back to B flat. Isn't that a great lyric? E flat, back to B flat. Then we got E flat. It reminds me, beef, more than you should. Now this third line is up there on the top right hand side near that goose in the picture there.
Hello.
And you've got the same third line is the same as the first line. Then you've got the last line down the bottom. It's an E flat chord. We're going to run out of time. Then F. Da 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 da. Anyway, I'm going to put the song on again, and we're going to learn this tomorrow. How about that, folks? Lovely to see you. Send me an email. Let me know what you're thinking. We'll have a go at this tomorrow. Put it on again.